Salt Lake City! Thank you for coming out tonight to help us honor Utah's World Cup champions. I want to thank my friend, Salt Lake County Mayor Jenny Wilson, for joining me to help me with this special Key to the City presentation. We are lucky to have three World Cup champions here in Utah. And we are also lucky that they are setting an example both on and off the field. So please help us welcome these three incredible women. As a defender for the national team, she's been described as a brick wall. Coming back from injury, she played an impressive 492 minutes for the U.S. team. A two-time World Cup champion, off the field, she is dedicated to inspiring young girls to be agents of change in their community through her work with Goals for Girls. Utah Royals and U.S. Women's National Team defender, Kelly O'Hara. Just 9 minutes into the semi-final match against England, she put the U.S. back in the lead with an incredible header that found the back of the net. As a global ambassador for grassroots soccer, she uses the power of the game to educate and inspire at-risk youth in developing nations. Utah Royals and U.S. Women's National Team forward, Kristen Press. Alum, playing a combined 540 minutes for this year's legendary team. As both a former captain of the U.S. Women's National Team and the current captain of the Utah Royals, she is a natural-born leader. Please help us welcome tonight's final honoree, two-time World Cup champion defender, Becky Sauerbrunn. People in this audience were glued to their TV the morning of the season. I was one of them. I was trying to kind of do as many of us were like grab a little piece of toast or something, but it was such riveting, exciting action that even that was hard to do. So thank you. Thank you for your commitment to the sport. Thank you for being Utahns along with your home areas. And thank you so much for the work you've done to support sport, women, and just create a little fun for us. So grateful. So we all know the outcome. U.S. Women's National Team won the 2019 World Cup after beating the Netherlands in the final by a score of 2-0. This is the fourth World Cup victory for the U.S. Women's National Team. And the last time they didn't win a match in this tournament was 2015. And I think more importantly, look at the amazing work that this team has done to fight for equal pay and civil rights. $28 eight members of the team have sued the U.S. Soccer Federation for gender discrimination. And the Relentless team makes us proud for all they do on and off the field. And I have to just, before I close my remarks, share that I take a lot of pride in, along with Mayor Biskupski, serving as a mayor in this valley, a female mayor in this valley. And I take pride because what I want is every child, every young woman, to feel that they have a future, the future that they would like to have, whatever it may be. And not everyone wants to be a mayor, and perhaps not everyone wants to be a successful world leader in the game of soccer, but we should be stepping up as women to support and to create an example for every child, every woman, and every young woman. So I'm proud of that. And I know that the mayor and I have some impact, but the impact you three are having, the Royals team, and women in soccer, it is amazing. I only wish that if my 1972-year-old, 7-year-old self had the same opportunities young women do in this sport today, and it's because of women like this. So thank you.
Well, I think we're going to have a word from you, and then I'll say some closing remarks. Does that work?
That's great. Well, thank you, Mayor, for this incredible honor, and thank you really to Salt Lake City for welcoming Kristen, Kelly, and myself, and really all the Utah Royals to your city, and we're so grateful for that. We have felt your reception, and we're very appreciative of that. And to Kelly and Kristen, who I have known for many years, we have fought both on and off the field, and it is an honor to be in this fight with you for better working conditions and for equal pay. And to make this short and sweet, if there is anything that this crazy journey continues to teach me, it is to believe in women, to empower women, and to invest in women. So thank you.
A woman. All right. So I'm going to take us back for just a second, because this was a point that the mayor and I certainly can remember. In 1973, female tennis superstar Billie Jean King accepted a challenge to play a match against former number one ranked men's tennis player Bobby Riggs. 50 million people tuned in to watch Billy play Bobby, and 50 million people watched Billie Jean King beat Bobby Riggs in the Battle of the Sexes. Just the year before, the Equal Rights Amendment gained traction in Congress, and Title IX was enacted into law. Each of these victories was credited with igniting a boom in women's participation in sports and for empowering women to advocate for equal pay in all sectors of the workforce. Throughout this summer, though, 750 million people around the world were captivated by the U.S. women's national team. 750 million people watched as this group of extraordinary women faced down every challenge on the field. And in between matches, the world was listening while these women made the case for equal treatment and equal pay. Judging by the reception these women received from Paris to New York City, I don't think the world is just listening. I think the world is saying, it's time. Amen. Kristen, Becky, and Kelly, you honor us today with your presence, and we are proud to be able to call you our own. At a time when Americans needed it most, you showed the world what the red, white, and blue on your jerseys stood for. Those colors are not just about competition and strength. but about fairness and equity, values which are central in Salt Lake City and certainly to the county. As mayor of Utah's capital city, I have given out very few keys to the city. Each of you is receiving this recognition today because your performance, both on and off the field, has inspired many and will open doors for countless others. More than champions, you are trailblazers, ensuring that those who come behind you are better positioned to score. If nothing else, you and your teammates have shown every little girl and boy that we as women are stronger when we stand together, and that we are an unstoppable force when we actually work together. In 1973, 50 million people did show up to watch Billy beat Bobby, and it did ignite a boom. In 2019, 750 million people watched the U.S. Women's National Team outplay the world and beat the critics. And what I think we all hope becomes nothing short of a revolution. On behalf of Salt Lake City, it is my honor on this 22nd day of July 2019 to present each of you with a key to the city.
Yeah.